Writers have said down the ages that we have a God-sized hole within ourselves, and most of us may not be aware of that. And so we try to fill that void within with lots of other things, both temporal and immaterial, but none of it satisfies.
I think the world is getting away from monasteries. I mean, they're not so usual anymore, and they're not so known anymore, and I think they seem to be very set apart from the world. You know, you see monks in robes, but inside the robes are people. And in this monastery, men of the prairie, you know, there's carpenters and farmers and mechanics and woodworkers and beekeepers. And so what they're doing is incorporating God and peace in their work. And I think that's why monasteries are important. They set a really good example of what we can all do. And they just make more of a habit of it.
In our rule, the Rule of Benedict, it says to begin all things with prayer and ask God to bring them to perfection. And that will bring you to a healthier relationship with work, because you may not worry so much about, am I doing this exactly as it needs to be done in order to satisfy my own pride or to impress other people? You're working in a personal relationship with God.
It seems like we misunderstand when we look at work as this drudgery, because really it's something amazing that's given to us, and sure, we might fail at times, but that's the only way we get better. It progresses.
Well, if we're connected with the church and with God, then it's possible for us to grow in our relationship to God and to others, or grow in grace. And by doing that, we grow in holiness.
How do you be present in the moment? One of the things we have to pay attention to more, I think, is learning to be in the present. And by being in the present, we're going to be more aware of who's around us, our community right now, and also being aware of God and how do we mirror that.
Well, at least for me, that I choose that monastic style of life, it's a great experience to feel that I am doing what I like, that I, something that I love, that I believe, and I can share that with other people also, and to invite them to, according to their own lives, to do also, to be happy, to continue, I mean, to enjoy whatever they do.
You know, that's the gift of presence, just being there. You say, I could be doing something else, but just the fact that you were there, you didn't do anything special, but the fact that you were there makes a big statement.
Right.
For those struggling with these issues of incompleteness, unfulfillment, I would suggest that perhaps three simple things are to slow the pace of one's life, to stop, and to take some time for prayer and meditation each day. A second thing would be do something kind for someone else each day, no matter how small it is. The smallest gift can be huge for someone in need. And the third would be to stop and give thanks each day. A spirit of gratitude opens us to the gifts God gives us and makes us aware of something beyond ourselves.
By having your day built into where is the transcendent God, incorporating that into our life. Where is our community, our family and friends? How do we incorporate that in our life? And work is really important. It shouldn't just, I mean, sometimes it's drudgery, but work shouldn't be always drudgery. It's one of the things that helps make us more complete again. So having all those elements together and being present in the moment, I think will make us feel like we've been created, you know, so that we're whole, so that we're complete.